Coming up, a look at the Operations Management Suite's security and audit solution, which provides deep and actionable insights into the security of your hybrid cloud environment. We'll explore how it helps you to understand the security state of your resources and identify vulnerabilities, and detect active threats and quickly investigate malicious activities. I'm joined by Principal Program Manager Sarah Fender. Welcome.
Good to be here.
Now, when people think of the Operations Management Suite, they think of it as the operational hub for their entire environment across Windows, Linux, public cloud, and private cloud, enabling them to utilize log analytics, automation, backup, site recovery, and also security.
Right, and we've heard from a lot of you that increasingly operations and security management go hand in hand. So we've added some new capabilities to OMS, which makes it even easier for you to manage security across your hybrid IT environments.
So how does it work?
Well, the OMS security solution collects and analyzes security data from your resources, wherever they reside, to provide security insights. So this helps you to identify potential security issues and take action quickly.
Cool. So can we take a look at some of those insights?
Absolutely. So we're in the Operations Management Suite portal now, and we're just going to jump right into the security solution. Let's look at data for the last 7 days. So here we can assess the security of a variety of different controls. We refer to these as security domains. So, for example, we can see if anti-malware software is deployed and being kept up to date, if systems have any missing or critical security updates, which can create a vulnerability, kind of making them an easy target for attackers, information about inbound and outbound network communications. And if we wanted to learn more about any of these, we just simply click in. So, for example, if we look at the identity and access domain, we can see here, for example, if failed login attempts exceed the norm, certainly looks like what's happening here. We can see which systems are being targeted and also which user accounts are being used. This might help us to identify a dictionary-based attack.
Okay, cool.
So one other thing I want to show you is this new baseline assessment feature. So working with industry partners, including the US and UK defense departments and many, many others, Microsoft defines and publishes a set of recommended security baselines for Windows servers.
Right, and these baselines are what people will be familiar with from Windows Server security baselines.
Absolutely.
Right.
So now OMS is assessing the security of your servers against this set of baselines. And if it sees any mismatches or any vulnerabilities, it surfaces those. They're prioritized for you here. And we can click in to view more information about the specific rule. So in this case, we see that there's a rule relative to audit policy. And if we expand this view here, we can see that the expected result is for that to be turned on, but it's not configured at all for this particular computer.
So is there a way that the system surfaces to you things that you need to take action on?
Yeah, so notable issues helps you identify areas that require your attention across all of these different domains. And issues are prioritized so you know where to focus first. And most of these rules are built in, but you can also create your own custom rule. So for example, if you wanted to keep a close eye on login attempts using your CEO's credentials, you could do that. So we've created a custom notable issue for that here.
So that's great for highlighting vulnerabilities we can take action on, but what about active threats? Are those flagged as well?
Yes, absolutely. One of the more exciting new capabilities is threat intelligence, which enables you to see network communications to and from malicious IP addresses. Here we're comparing network traffic to global threat intelligence from Microsoft, in this case at least partially sourced from our digital crimes unit.
Nice, okay.
So you can now visualize the source of these attacks by geography, and you can click in to get additional insights. So here we can see that this traffic was associated with a known botnet. In another instance here, we see darknet. So these orange arrows indicate inbound communication attempts, but what's really alarming is this red outbound communication that we see. So this indicates that one of these computers is communicating with the known bad actor who could be executing commands on this system or exfiltrating data.
So what's next? Once an attack has been identified, how do we start to remediate?
Well, let's start by investigating a bit. So we might want to look at other activities that were occurring on this particular computer.
Using the powerful search there.
Absolutely. And then we can also narrow that search based on the time frame. So if we wanted to look at just those events that occurred at the same time or close to the same time as the outbound traffic we saw earlier.
Right.
So we can narrow that time window here. So there's a lot of different kinds of security alerts are available. We can see different activity types and who signed in. And we'll look at in particular at who has been accessing this computer during that time frame. So this particular account looks suspicious, Joseph Benson. That doesn't match my company account naming policy. So let's see what else Joseph Benson has been accessing.
So you're just using a simple search query here, but you could create a much more complex search query if you wanted to.
Absolutely. So I'm going to group the results here by computer. And I can see at a glance that he's been accessing a number of different computers, including one that contains PII. So definitely not good. So based on this insight, I could take further action. So I might want to block this particular user account or block traffic out to that known bad IP address.
Okay, so if you're an admin and you've already got OMS set up and running, how do I get started with the security and audit solution?
You can simply add the security solution from the OMS solutions gallery. So let's take a look at that. And you can see there are lots of different solutions that are available, and I think they're adding new ones virtually every week. So just find the security solution and click on it, and for new users, you'll have an option to add it here.
Okay, so I don't need to deploy any additional management or infrastructure servers on-prem to take advantage of this functionality.
You know, if you're already using OMS to manage these servers, there's really nothing extra for you to do.
So in summary, you get the benefit of integrated operations and security.
That's it.
So how does somebody get started?
Well, if you're already using OMS, you can simply add the security solution as we just saw. Mm-hmm. And if you're not already using OMS, you can use the link below to sign up for a free trial.
Great, thanks. And keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest tech updates. Thanks for watching, and bye for now.